on the humanitarian front, our humanitarian coordinator for Lebanon. All right, good afternoon, and apologies for the delay. I can tell you that the Secretary General is indeed alarmed by the escalating situation along the Blue Line. He's very concerned about the large number of civilian casualties being reported by the Lebanese authorities, as well as the thousands of displaced persons amidst the most intense exchange of fire across the Blue Line since October of last year. He expresses grave concern for the safety of civilians both in southern Lebanon and in northern Israel, as well as the UN staff in those areas. Expect a more official statement to be issued at some point. The message for both the special coordinator and the head of the UN peacekeeping force is the same, which is that there is no military solution that will make either side safer. With the well-being of civilians on both sides of the Blue Line and the stability of the region at stake, space must be given for diplomatic efforts to succeed. All involved parties in this conflict must honor their responsibilities to protect civilians and ensure the safety and security of all UN personnel and assets.
Thank you, Steph. Does the Secretary General condemn Israel's closing of the Al Jazeera Bureau? And the Secretary General has talked for many months now about he does not want to see escalation in Lebanon. We are now seeing it. It's happening. It's in front of our eyes, and it's a day before high-level week.
The message to the parties that are firing at each other across the Blue Line, to all the parties involved in this conflict, is step back from the brink. Stop the escalation. We have mechanisms through which to address these issues, notably on the security issue through UNIFIL, on the broader political issues through the work of our special coordinators in the region. As we just said, there is no military solution at this point that will make anyone in either country any safer. Pam.
We mourn the loss of innocent lives everywhere, including those killed in Israel on October 7th. And
this is President of the General Assembly, and I'm already tired. There we go.